Hi, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I want to show you how to upload files with Struts. So I want to show you how the file upload works in Struts, and I'm starting off here with a simple Struts project. It was created with Maven, so it's just a basic Maven project with the required dependencies there, Struts core, Struts convention, and the servlet API. A basic plugin configuration there to force 1.8 JDK to compliance. And you can see I've got a web.xml file here, which is just the standard struts mapping for struts 2.5, making sure that I've got the struts prepare and execute filter configured there. And so that's where you want to start off. Now, you are going to need a couple of dependencies in order to get the struts file upload facilities to work. You need to add in commons file upload and commons IO. Now, everything's done through struts. It's just struts needs these particular packages in order for the struts upload facilities to work. Now, how does struts get you to upload a file, make it possible to do that through the browser? Well, the key is the struts form for uploading a file. So I'm going to create a new JSP page here. I'm going to call it index.jsp right there in the web app folder. And I'm going to add my tag lib and page directive here, get rid of the basic stuff that it gives me and start off from scratch. So I'm going to include the struts tags and basic page directive. I'll throw in the requisite HTML and body tags. And then in here is really where the meat of the movement happens. What you need is you need this form tag. And I'm going to copy and paste this in here. And I guess we got to end that form tag to make everybody happy. The method is post, and the encryption type is multi-part. That's standard. That should stay the same for any single file upload that you're going to do. And then the action, well, that's going to be the name of the action class that I create on the server to support this. So I'm going to create that action class in just a minute, but that has to point to an action component on your server. And then there's a couple of entries that you need in here. You need to specify the name of the file being uploaded. Uploaded file becomes very important. That becomes extremely important later because I need to have a property of type file in the action I'm going to create that maps to this. I also have to have a property called whatever this is and then file name. And since I ended this in file, it's actually going to be a setter name, set uploaded file, file name, which is going to sound a bit redundant, but it will still work. So you'll see how it goes. Now, this is it. That is the key. You can decorate this with whatever HTML you want, but this is the key to getting a form upload configured inside of Struts. It's that form tag. Now, I do need an action named file upload, and that action has to have a property of type file named uploaded file. And actually, it doesn't need a property with that name. It needs a setter with that name to be explicit. It doesn't need a property, it just needs the setter. You can name the property whatever you want. I'm going to name it the same thing just because I think it's going to look nice. But you'll see the names will differ when I go in and create the file name property. Okay, so let's do that. Let's create that. So I'm going to create a new class. It is going to be in the com.mcnz.struts package. Make sure your package ends with struts, otherwise the annotations won't find it. I'm going to call this class my file upload action, and I'm going to make it a subclass of action support. So I'll browse for action support, and there it is there. And I think that's everything that I need. Okay, that looks good to begin with. Now, this will be mapped to the action file upload. Remember in my JSP, I said the action for this form is file upload. That means I have to specify that the action here is file upload as well. I'll organize my imports in just a moment. It can't find that, so I need to do an import. And also, if the execute method that I'm going to have in here is successful, I'm going to forward the processing to a page called results.jsp. So there's a couple of things you need to do just to set up the entire action class. Now, as I said, It's barking at me because of a couple of missed imports. So I'll click Organize Imports, import that action class from Struts 2. And then those errors will go away. I think that just wants me to put in a serialization ID, and I will reject that. But it's just a warning, so it's not a big deal. Now, as I mentioned, over here, the name of the file is uploaded file. That means I need to declare a method called setUploadedFile. And it just makes sense that I should also have a property that will catch that. So I'm going to declare a property called uploadedFile of type file. And then I will add a setter for that. And it's the setter that the Struts framework is going to call. The setter will not initialize this file by its name. It'll find the matching setter that corresponds to this property here and pass the file object into it, and then uploaded file will get assigned to that. Now, I do believe that's barking because I don't have java.io imported, so I will organize my imports. Import java.io.file, and those errors will go away. Now, the other thing that the uploaded file doesn't give you the name of the file that is being uploaded, so you want to actually have a property that maps to the name of the uploaded file. I'm going to call it uploaded file name. Now, the method is actually the name of the file as specified here, plus the word file name, which means I'm gonna have to have a setter called uploaded file, set uploaded file, file name. So the word file is gonna end up in there twice, but in my property, I'm not doing that because that sounds redundant. So you'll see what I mean here. I'm gonna have to have a method called set uploaded file, file name. So it's called set uploaded file, file name, and again, just because you have to append file name to whatever is listed here as the name of the file. But I set uploaded file name with only one file in it to the name of the file being passed in here. But this now gives me the name of the file as it's uploaded, and it actually gives me the file. Now from here, well, you can code an execute method, and you can do whatever you want in your execute method. Now it just makes sense to me that in your execute method, you would probably just want to save that file. So I'm going to create a new variable up here called local directory, and I'm going to set it to C:// temp. So that's where I'm going to upload all of my files. And in the execute method, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new local file, and that's a local file output stream based on that local directory, so ctemp, and the name of the uploaded file. So if someone uploads a file called image.jpg, I will now create an output stream to c:temp/image.jpg, and then I will save the file that was passed in, that uploaded file, into that directory there. So that's what happens here. I create a new file output stream essentially to save the uploaded file, and then I call the file utils object and its copy file method to take that uploaded file and save it locally. I'm going to do an organize imports to get rid of those errors. So source, organize imports, click Control S, and now this allows me to basically take that file that was uploaded and save it into the temp directory. And so that's the meat of the method there. And now what do I have to do in my final page? Well, I really don't have to do much. I need a results.jsp page. I'm gonna create a new JSP called results.jsp. And I'm not gonna do much here. I'm gonna paste some code in. You can find this code in GitHub. It's also on the server side. And what I'm just going to do is I'm going to say to the user, hey, the file was uploaded properly. So uploaded file name, that's a property here of the action class. So I can access any of these properties in the JSP that I forward to. Notice that that results.jsp is forwarded to. I don't know if forward's a good name. It's rendered upon success. So we've accessed all of those properties. And so this will just give the user that information that, hey, this was uploaded, that file was uploaded properly. And there we go, that's the whole thing. So now all I have to do is just take this file. Oh, I'm going to do a Maven update project just to make sure that all of the libraries in the POM file have been updated. So that looks good there. And then I will do a run as Maven install. That just makes me feel better, although I'm not sure if that's actually necessary. I think maybe when I run this, it'll do a Maven install anyways, but old habits die hard. And now I'll say run on server for this JSP and deploy it to the Tomcat server. And you can see this file directory comes up. Now I'm actually going to take that file name and I'm not going to upload it right there. I'm actually going to paste this URL into Chrome. Okay, so now we'll see how it works in Chrome. And I'm also going to bring up that temp directory. So you can actually see right there, there's my temp directory with no files in it. So I'm going to choose a file. So I will choose a file, and then why don't I see there's my friend Callie there. There's a copy of my book. So I'll take that and I will upload it, click submit, and now it says the file was uploaded successfully, and then you can see the file right there. Although actually the property isn't coming through. And let's check why that is. Oh, and actually it's pretty obvious. The property here in the results JSP is uploaded file name. I've got a property called uploaded file name, but I don't have a getter for it. You need the getter for it in order for Struts to be able to find it. So I need to just go source, generate getters and setters, and make sure that I have a getter for that uploaded file name. Click Control S. Just do a quick restart of the server and then run that one more time. Bring up localhost, bring up the temp directory, do a refresh. We'll actually do a back button, do a refresh. And now let's see if I can upload that picture of Callie. Click submit. And now it says the Kali selfie was uploaded successfully, and you can see it right there. Now, I will say in the GitHub directory, or even on the server side, I did add an extra method. And so I added this cool method in here that does a directory listing and returns a file list. So if I take a look at the file upload action, I added this in. This will actually go into the local directory and return a set showing all of the different files that are in that directory. So I'm actually going to go to that directory and just delete those two files for now. I'm going to do an organizing of the imports once again. Lots of neat stuff has been added there. So organize imports. That's the java.util set that I want. Click Control S. But now I've got this method called getFileList. And what I was thinking was instead of just doing, hey, you know, you uploaded that successfully, why not give them the chance to upload more files and even do a directory listing? So I get kind of crazy on the server side, and I get kind of crazy if you look at the code in the GitHub account. I'm just gonna paste it on in here just to show you what it looks like. But instead of just this little message here, what I've done is I've put the file upload back on. So that code there is just this code here. It's all formatted on a couple of lines, but that's the file upload again. And uploaded file, yeah, it's the right name. And then what I do was I say, hey, the file was uploaded successfully, so long as that uploaded file name is there. I guess it should always be there, so maybe that if statement isn't necessary. And then I have a little heading for a directory listing. And what I do in the directory listing is, if there's nothing in the directory, I say, hey, there's no files in the directory. There should be files in the directory, just like that uploaded file name should come up. But I guess potentially maybe somebody would get to this JSP directly and they wouldn't be. And then if there are files in there, what we will do is we will go over this file list. And again, that file list comes from this get file list method here inside of the file upload action class. And then we list out all of the files in that directory. So I'm going to save that. I'll restart the server just to make sure that we're getting the latest. I'm going to click the back button and refresh on that page. I'll take a look at this temp folder. And now I'm going to choose a file. I'm going to upload a picture of San Francisco. And now it says, hey, there's one file in that directory. And I guess that's what happens when Democrats run your city. And then I'm going to choose another file, take a look at Cali there, and I will submit that. Now the Cali selfie is in there. And then, I don't know, why don't we choose that Pickering of Springfield cover right there and submit it as well. And so now I think I've got a much nicer application. It's not only uploading files, but I don't have to click the back button to upload them again. I can do one after another, and then it even gives me a listing of all the files that are inside of this directory. And I think that's a pretty good coverage of the Struts file upload use case. And there you go, that's how easy it is to upload files using Struts. Now, if you enjoyed that tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there. Got lots of great tutorials on Struts, Hibernate, Spring, all enterprise frameworks, anything that has to do with Java in general. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on YouTube.